Hi, I'm Rick Hatfield with TGW.com. I'm alongside Brian Lamb, the VP of Golf Club Operations for Acushnet. And we're looking out over the Acushnet Carlsbad Golf Club Manufacturing Facility. And Brian was nice enough to give us a great tour. And I want to just start talking about how the product comes in the door. And I know you guys have gone to great extents to make sure that you've got the quality control before you even get the product. But I saw you guys testing a lot of the product after you've received it, I think even looking for tighter tolerances.
Yeah, we've spent the last 20 plus years working with the best of the best in the golf club supply chain environment to find people that we can partner with that can make the best quality parts at the highest precision. And then we spend a lot of time here making sure that all of that product meets our specifications. We're looking for weights that are not only plus or minus 3 grams, but we also get that product weight sorted in boxes so that when we're building custom clubs for you, we know that we can hit those very tight swing weight tolerances on the product.
Yeah, along with that, I noticed people testing shafts as they were getting them into the factory, testing probably grips for weights.
Yeah.
Everything you can measure is probably getting measured.
You're absolutely right. Yeah. You know, we've got critical parameters on all of those products. With a grip, it's not only weight, but it's length of the grip. We want to make sure that all of the lengths of your grips are the same so that your grips look the same to you and feel the same. When it comes to shafts, it's not only the weighted shaft, but the balance point.
Oh.
And then also the cosmetic criteria. Mm-hmm. Does the paint stick, right? This isn't the old college test where -5, the paint fell off, right? This is binary. It's either passes or it fails. We've got every test that you can imagine for wear and tear on our products. From how well the chrome holds up under play, last thing you want is your chrome on your wedges wearing off, to the durability of the shaft coating so that when you take that golf club in and out of your golf bag, the paint doesn't wear off of the shaft. And then the head as well, we're testing the durability of the coating on the head to make sure that that coating doesn't wear off during play. You know, we want you to play golf with a piece of jewelry, and we want that jewelry to look good, not just when you get it, but a year after you get it and 2 years after you get it. We want that product to look good for the life of the product.
Just a couple things we saw you doing in there. First of all, we saw you putting the heads into a humidity machine of some sort.
Yeah, salt spray machine. We put it in a chamber which has a fog of salt and high temperature moisturized air. And we're trying to force those products to rust. And our criteria is the golf club can never rust.
Another thing we saw you do, we saw you shooting ball bearings into the crown of a three-wood,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
We saw another guy with an X-Acto knife scratching the paint surface, trying to get it to peel, which he couldn't. We saw some sandblasting, I think, going on of some sort back there. It was amazing the extents that they were doing to actually try to damage the clubs, and to our view, we couldn't see any.
Yeah, we have copied a lot of automotive industry tests for paint durability. And some of those are, you know, with that knife, the crosshatch, it's how well does the paint stick to the substrate? And so if we can cut it with a knife and put some tape on it and pull it off, that fails. That's going to fail in the life of the product. The ball bearing is how durable is it? How, if you, you know, you wouldn't, but your friend might borrow your club and hit that golf ball off the crown of your club.
Yeah.
We want to make sure that that paint doesn't bubble up or pop up if a friend of yours hits the ball off the top.
Certainly not me.
Right.
So that was awesome. So we've got the product in. We've tested it for probably the tightest tolerances in the industry. And then we start building the product. Can you just walk us through that?
Yeah, we specialize in cellular manufacturing here. And we want to get the product velocity, as we call it, up as high as possible. We want your golf club to get through the factory from start to finish in less than 2 hours.
Oh, wow.
So we have small cells, and it's down to the minimum number of operations it takes to build a golf club. And within those cells, we build product throughout the day. And we can build roughly 100 sets per day.
Wow. Now,
In each cell.
Yeah.
So the philosophy in every one of those cells is to build product on target, not just in spec.
Okay.
And so by on target, you know, as we discussed earlier, if you order a set of golf clubs that's 1 degree upright, and the tolerance is plus or minus a half a degree, we want to ship those exactly at 1 degree upright. Because if you wanted it at 1.5 degrees upright, you as a pro would have ordered it at 1.5.
Right.
And so We currently ship loft and lie at plus or minus an eighth of a degree. And there's many products that go out even tighter than that.
The machinery used was very impressive to me. First of all, just the cutting the shaft. It was robotic, it measured it, it confirmed it, it cut it precisely to the shaft length desired. The loft and lie machines were all, I don't know if they're digital or camera-based, but they're within 1/8 of a degree when they're getting the loft and lies dialed in. The gripping machines, we've got lasers that align the scoring grooves, so it's next to impossible to get that grip on anything but perfect.
Yeah.
A lot of this machinery was developed in-house?
Correct.
Okay.
If we can't find a machine that's capable enough for us, we go and design and build that machine ourselves. Every machine that you saw in the factory here is something that our engineers have designed, and then our maintenance crew and engineering crew has fabricated, put together, and then we use that in the factory. Some of the interesting things about that is you don't see any associates clamping down any of the machines. It's all magnetically clamped down. And most of the machines are barcode readable, where all of the specs for the order that you put in are fed into the machine, and the machine moves to the appropriate cut length or to the appropriate loft and lie settings.
When it comes to golf clubs, probably drivers especially, I hear sometimes people refer in a negative way that drivers are like snowflakes and there are no two alike, period. By the time you weld the face and you get the shaft, you insert the shaft, the amount of epoxy used, the swing weight, the gram weight. I got to say, after what I saw today, I'm going to totally disagree with that, because the attention to detail and the precision with every aspect of building the club is unbelievable.
Thank you.
Yeah.
When it comes to the metalwoods, we spend a lot of time working with our supply partners to make sure that every 9.5 driver is like every other 9.5 driver. We spend massive amounts of time working to make sure that the golf club that you got fit with is exactly the one that we ship to you, because we want to make all the 9.5 family a snowflake, but we want it to be all of them as precise as possible.
Right.
So it's how we fit, it's how we build to the clubs we fit, and it's how we, you know, believe that we are the leader in customization.
And I got to say, probably the other thing that really impressed me is the tenure of your employees here at Acushnet. You mentioned that I think the average employee tenure is 17, maybe 20 plus years, and that says something for the company.
Yeah.
And the management, I think.
It's a great company to work for. We all love working here. I've been here for 22 years, and when I walk the factory floor, I see a lot of faces that were here before I started. And there's a sense of pride here in building
product.
You
can see the pride. Just from the outside looking in, it's one of the first things I noticed.
The other great advantage we have is we have a lot of associates on the floor that play golf. And so they have a vested interest in making great golf clubs, because they want to make sure that if they're making their own golf club, they're making the best possible stuff.
Right. Well, that was great. We had a great day, Brian. Thanks again for your time.
Thank you. Great to have you.
Just rest assured, know that the Titleist golf club that you're fit for, or the Titleist golf club that you order, is going to be exactly the Titleist golf club that you get.